I welcome all of you again, and I thank you for your faith for being here this morning. Today's homily, I titled it, Peace Be With You. Peace Be With You. After the resurrection, two of the disciples of Jesus Christ were walking to a village called Emmaus. And this village is about 7 miles from Jerusalem. Remember, after the resurrection, the disciples didn't know what to do. The tomb was now empty. Christ was gone. And perhaps these two disciples were just going back home. Perhaps they were just going back to their former business because their master was gone. They were totally discouraged and dejected. They were in grief and despair. But as they were traveling, suddenly one man joined them, and they were conversing. And this man showed himself to be Christ at the breaking of bread. And the two apostles were really happy. They were amazed. And they didn't know that they were conversing with Jesus Christ. And so they went back to Jerusalem to share this message with the rest of the apostles. And as they were sharing the message, the story, the testimony with them, they couldn't even believe what they were saying. They were still doubting. And suddenly Jesus Christ showed up and said, Peace be with you. Peace be with you. And no one had the courage to say, Who are you? Remember, the doors were still locked. How did this person get in here? So that fear was there. Jesus Christ did amazing things. Number one, Jesus Christ calmed their fears by saying, Peace be with you. That peace was a sign of love and forgiveness to them all. Secondly, Jesus Christ showed them his wounds in his hands and his feet and invited them to touch him. I'm feeling that Jesus Christ is really alive. And thirdly, he asked him a question, Do you have anything to eat here? And he gave him fish. He ate it. He said, I am really the one. I'm not the ghost. The apostles now rejoice that our Lord has truly risen. As Jesus Christ appeared to the apostles today, in midst of their fear, their anxiety, Jesus Christ is appearing to us today. As we receive him in Holy Communion, as we see him on the cross today, his wounds, on his hands, on his side, on his feet, Jesus saying, Peace unto you. Now sometimes we feel that anxiety in our lives. That fear. Something is keeping us awake in the middle of the night. We feel like being happy, but we're not happy. Something is wrong somewhere. But when that moment occurs in our lives, we have a true friend. And that true friend is Jesus Christ. On Friday, I was talking with one person from Nigeria, a woman. This woman called me and she was just shedding tears. She had miscarriage. And she was at a point that for her she couldn't bear it anymore. Because that was the third time she had miscarried. She asked so many questions. She prayed to God and asked God so many questions and received no answer. She switched off her phone for more than 3 weeks and disconnected with all her friends on Facebook, Instagram, and all the social media. She just wants to be herself. So while I was talking with her, I encouraged her with the words from the passages of Scripture and gave her that hope. And let her know that it is not the end of the road yet, that God has not abandoned her. At the end of the discussion, she thanked me for my time. And she reassured me that she would give back life. She gave back to the church. And she will renew her faith, her trust, her hope in God. Life is not easy. Sometimes the things we never anticipated in our lives come our way. And I say it again that the way you handle what happens to you will either defy you or destroy you. I don't really know what is happening in your life right now. Maybe the storm of life is blowing you up and down, up and down. Maybe you have doubts for a better future. Maybe things are not working well in your family right now. Maybe you have experienced a shocking death of a beloved one or a beloved friend. Maybe the kind of sickness you never anticipated in life suddenly surfaced and you are shaking. Things are not normal anymore. And you are not happy. Sometimes you begin to blame others, blame people around you for what is happening to you. Because for you, they don't seem to understand what you are going through. Maybe you are at the point of throwing in the towel. You can't take it anymore. I want you to listen to the voice of Jesus Christ today. Asking me this question, why are you troubled? Why are you troubled? Why do you raise questions in your heart? Don't you trust me anymore? I am here for you. And I want you to picture Jesus Christ saying to you today, peace be with you. Peace be with you in the midst of your anxiety, in the midst of your fear, in the midst of your sickness. Peace be with you. Receive this peace. Feel the presence of Christ in your life. Renew your faith. Wipe your tears. Get back to life. Christ is with you. I don't know what your problem is. I don't even know how heavy your problem is. But I know that one thing is that Jesus Christ, who gave that peace to the apostles that were troubled in heart then, is granting the same peace to you. And we have to receive it there be peace in our families. Let there be peace in our church. Let there be peace in the West. Peace in Africa. Peace in Asia. Peace in the Middle East. Peace in the world. Let us pray. And we say this directly to prayers. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change. Courage to change the things I can. And wisdom to make the difference. Living one day at a time. Enjoying one moment at a time. Accepting hardship as a pathway to peace. Trusting that you will make all things right if I surrender to his will. That I may be reasonably happy in this life and supremely happy with him forever.